tonight. God bless his heart.
It's Kurt.
Kurt, welcome to this church. We are so glad that you've come. Kurt, this is an old-fashioned church, just worships God. Very important, and I'm Pastor Marlowe. Starting my 57th year here in December at the same place. Same job, same location. I certainly am glad to have you tonight. God bless you. I hope you feel at home, comfortable in our midst. We're very informal. We're very explosive. We're very impromptu. We're very spontaneous. Other words I could use. But I know one thing. The Spirit of the living God is here tonight. I said the Spirit of the living God is here tonight. That felt so good. I think I'll say it again. Praise God. The Spirit of the living God is here tonight. Hallelujah. Let it run loose. Burn the barn down tonight. Praise God. Amen. Let it be a barn burner tonight. Let the Holy Ghost come in. Shake you. Wiggle your toe at least for the glory of God. Amen. Shake your hand. Tell God how much you love him tonight. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. I appreciate the Lord so very much. And I appreciate the plan of salvation. I will be up here just a few moments. I took enough time this afternoon, my allotted time, and some of yours, I'm sure. But I want you to know tonight that I feel confident in my spirit. The Bible, Book of Hebrews, isn't it? Is that chapter 10? What verse is that? Casting not away your confidence. Verse 35, casting not away your confidence, which hath great recompense of reward. Cast not away your confidence. Cast not away, therefore, your confidence. I believe that tonight there's a surging feeling in my spirit. The candle of the Lord has not grown dim in these 82 years. Rather, it's burning brighter. I feel the vigor of a young man. I really do. I feel the vigor of Caleb. Joshua. The battle is over of the wilderness. We're coming out of the wilderness. When he said, give me my mountain. And they looked across, and you can smell tonight the grapes of Eschol. The fruit of the promised land. You can know that despite all that you may have been through as an individual, all that we have come through as the collective ecclesia of the body of Christ, fragmented sometimes, wounded sometimes. But the one thing we have not done in the Bradenton Church, and we will not do it, we will not castigate one of God's people. We will not throw and slander one of God's precious children. We will not be exalted to feel we are the only one that is going to heaven. The only one that God is talking to. Because it is a body. There will be a body. There is to be a collective ecclesia. I thank God I'm included. How many appreciate the rest of the company? Praise our God. The rest of God's family. It's a wonderful thing tonight to feel the uplift in your wings. He that dwelleth in the secret place. Psalms 91. Of the Most High. Shall abide. Say it with me. Shall abide. Shall abide. Under the shadow of the Almighty. Praise God. I feel the shadow tonight of the Almighty. I feel him hovering near. Can you feel God hover near? You certainly can. Praise the name of the Lord. Many years ago, my father, of course, all of you know, you've heard it over and over and over again. If you've been here with me through the years and over again, over and over again, you've heard it. But let me tell it one more time. My father was a fisherman, commercial. The Barrows are seafaring people, boat builders, fishermen. And I was with a family on the Patty Ann, which was our family boat. We were about 10 miles offshore from Egmont Key.
Yes.
We were in the deep waters out there. We were in the sharp waters.
Yeah.
We were in the waters where mackerel come at night and cut the water. You can see the phosphorus of this, like glistening diamonds, as these mackerel race through the water in thousands of mackerel in schools. And my brother circled them like the mackerel fishermen did. And the Patty Ann, we dropped our light, the buoy, on the end of the net, the mackerel net, and it trailed overboard, and he went around them, and some of you are familiar with mackerel fishing, you know. And we were fishing at night, maybe 10 o'clock at night, and we were circling these fish. They didn't know it, but they were going to help feed us the next week. They were going into captivity, and they didn't know it. A lot of people are going into captivity tonight, and they don't know it. The United States of America, millions of people have sat still too long and watched our Constitution riddled with fragmentation. And now America is grasping and groping to find direction and purpose. Well, I've got news for them. If they'll go back to the book that Lincoln said, that Lincoln said, Abraham Lincoln said, when the nation forsakes this book, they will go to destruction. They will go to destruction. Lincoln said he read it every night. President Lincoln said it was the greatest piece of literature ever penned. Praise our God. It still is. Heaven and earth shall pass away. The carpenter of Galilee declared 2,000 years ago. But my word. Can you say it with me? But my word. My word shall never pass away. America needs to get back to the rock that is higher than they are. America needs to stand on the rock again. Praise our God. Praise our God. And when we were circling these fish, I was in the stern of the boat, and he was up in the bow of the boat, and he was steering, and he said, come up here, come up here. And I was walking the gunwale across the edge of the boat, and